Reaction of NaOH with halogens like chlorine, bromine, iodine, they react with all other halogens other than fluorine and two different conditions to produce two types of different products over here. Let us see what is the two different types of products. If you take halogen treated with water, what will be the product formed? Will be hydrogen halide and hypohalous acid. This is going to be the product that will be formed when X2 reacts with water. It forms HX and HOX, hydrogen halide and hypohalous acid. Now, if the same reaction, if I just take NaOH reacting with X2, the aqueous solution of this. Now, NaOH reacts with HX, it is acid, this is base. This is acid, base, salt will be formed, NaX. Again, this is acid, this is base. The salt of this one is NaOX. The hydrogens and coming with react with water forming H2O will be the leftover product over here. So NaX, NaOX and H2O, sodium halide, sodium hypohalite and water formation takes place. Now the important point, this will be happening in what conditions is in the cold conditions and the dilute NaOH, in the presence of dilute NaOH. But if you take the concentrated NaOH, what will happen? If I am taking the hot conditions, concentrated NaOH is taken, what will happen? Just try to remember, the hypohalite ion on heating will react with excess of oxygen and gives you halate ion XO3 minus. It will immediately undergo disproportionation to form X minus and XO3 minus. On strong heating, hypohalide is unstable. It will undergo disproportional to XO3 minus and X minus. And because of this, in hot conditions, the product that will be formed will be not only NaX, but sodium halate will be formed in the product, because XO minus further does not exist in hot conditions. XO3 minus exists, so sodium halate formation takes place.